What is up, ladies and gentlemen? What is going on? Goon has turned his stream on more than once a year. I know. Can you believe it? Welcome, everybody, to another installment of the Nexus Gaming Series Division A East. This is a best of three series between Cho'Gall's Angels versus First Band Cho'Gall. One second here. Make sure you guys can hear me, because I had some problems earlier. But I think we should be good. I think we should be fine. I think we should be okay. Let me know if you can hear me, or if it's too loud, or whatever. But yeah, Cho'Gall's Angels versus First Band Cho'Gall, Division A East. First Band Cho'Gall played in the Heroes International qualifier number one, where they look kind of, they made 30K have to do a double take. So I'm like, oh, okay, let's check it out. Let's see what's going on. And then on the other side, Cho'Gall's Angels, some names that I'm familiar with anyways. Traxx from GGS, the murky Deathwing main. Hey gamers, one second. They want my... They want my Twitch page. There we go. Friends coming out. But yeah, should be a pretty exciting game. Hopefully. I hope it is. I hope it isn't a complete, you know, blowout on either side here. But excited to see what kind of interesting drafts we come up with here. First map is going to be on Dragonshire. This is a First Band Cho'Gall map pick with Cho'Gall's Angels getting first pick. This is going to be confusing. Cho'Gall are in both names, so bear with me, all right? Bear with me. I might slip in some geese, too many geese, because that's what First Band Cho'Gall's name was beforehand, but... Let me let... or whatever. If you're new here, welcome. Appreciate you for stopping by. Drop a follow afterwards to see if this is a place you'd like to hang out. Like I said, I haven't been streaming a whole lot. Coming back to cast has been very nice, very fun. And this is kind of what I do, among a couple other things. I'll play some other games too from time to time. But my casting style is a little bit different than what you might be used to from what you've seen in previous or other streams. I am someone that likes to just discuss what's happening on the screen, drafts, kind of give my two cents a little bit. You're like, who's this guy? Goon, why do we care what you think? You don't have to care about what I think, but I've been playing this game for a long time. I've been casting, coaching, I've been doing other things. I'm the owner of Wild Heart Esports. I like to talk about the game and kind of impart some knowledge to people. But anyway, let's get right into this draft. Game number one, best of three series. You got the... Wait, why didn't that update? I'm upset. Why didn't that update? Okay, I got to fix this. My bad. This is Cho'Gubler's Angels. Cho'Gall's Angels versus First Band Cho'Gall. It's good on every screen except for this one. I missed this one. And they First Band the Cho'Gall, living up to their name, 100%. Yo, what up? What up? What's up, Lupus? First Band Cho'Gall outperforming most CCL teams. Ooh, true, actually. What's up, Uncle T? Good to see you, man. Welcome, everybody. Fringe, why are you... Hashtag Kappa, you're still with that. Speaking of old men, welcome, good to see you. Let's talk about this draft a little bit. We've got the Blaze Band and the Lucio Blaze. Generally flexible pick. We see Blaze most often in the off lane. We see him in the tank position from time to time. Don't really see him in the flex position. I've yet to see the Blaze come out in the flex position. I want to see it happen at some point. Generally a good hero. No one's ever mad at a first pick Blaze. Gives you good wave clear, good engage, good disengage as well. The Lucio, pretty annoying for a lot of teams to deal with. Hogger, strong hero. Especially in the flex position. You can take out camps. You can be in the four man playing for the camps. You can be clearing waves, good engage, etc., etc. And then Cho'Gall, they're, like I said, living up to the name. The first pick, Johanna, not bad. Good wave clear. The tri-bush control is a word that Johanna doesn't necessarily... when I think of control, I don't think of Johanna, especially when it comes to map control. She's definitely one that maybe she can control the map through her rotations because she can clear the waves faster. But yeah. Brightwing Diablo, pretty decent pairing. Diablo's pretty chunky. Brightwing's able to heal that beast up. And then obviously we see the Tychus as a Diablo counter. And then there's an Anduin there as well. Light Bomb, maybe combos. Some pulls, maybe follow up CC onto Diablo or something like that. Let me know if the volume's okay, guys. I feel like the music in my head might be a little too loud, but that's also just me being paranoid, potentially. The Medivh ban. We've seen Medivh on many maps paired with Diablo, kind of augmenting the rotational power that your team might lack, engaging onto back lines, ley line setups. The Junkrat. Junkrat made it through the ban, through the first phase, which is interesting. I can see them going tight. I can see why, because Diablo was shown so early, they take the Tychus. Tassar probably looking to be the bottom anchor here. Wave clear, potentially some vision later on. Urel on the top side, maybe. I don't know. I'm not sure what first ban Cho'Gall are going to be doing, but... So we've got a lot, and this is important, the Urel being picked up here, because two of the most powerful offlaners have been removed and nobody was picked. Most people would say that Urel is the next best option. Got the Sonya and we've got a Hanzo. Pretty, that Sonya, I haven't seen a Sonya in a while. Curious to see what time picks up here. Could see some, another melee champ or another melee hero, like Maiev. There we go. There's a Maiev here. I would say maybe a Thrall. Don't know if you want to go Thrall because of the Johanna, but Maiev's not bad. Can take camps, can rotate pretty aggressively. Strong initiation coming out of that hero for sure. But yeah, music is good to go. Okay. How does my mic sound relative to the music? Hopefully we're good. Is that local celebrity? Yes, it is. Local celebrity. Yeah. The wave clear on the side of Cho'Gall's Angels, not bad. The Johanna is a good way to augment. Make sure that your team has decent enough wave clear. You got the Tychus grenade that can clear that pretty quick. At level 4, you'll have Hanzo's explosion. Explosive arrow to help. Meanwhile, like, Maiev can do okay. Tassar is fine, but I don't really see Tassar rotating around too much. But all right, we'll get this out of the way for game number one. All right, game number one, ladies and gentlemen. Best of three series. On the left-hand side, we have Cho'Gall's Angels. We got Balrog playing the Tychus, Toasty Buns on the end, with Smart Killer on the Hanzo. Durka Dirk playing Johanna and Traxxex on the Sonya. And on the right in the red, we have first ban Cho'Gall. KJ Kags, you can call him KJ, on the Diablo, show playing Urel. Sweet Lucy on the Brightwing, super playing Tassadar, and time on the Maiev. Curious to see how this wave gets cleared, who gets the priority. I do like that Diablo's kind of lurking down here. Not entirely convinced. Ooh, they're already looking pretty aggressive there. Using the pull to save the Tychus. And that kind of puts Cho'Gall's Angels on a bit of a defensive posturing. They're not going to be able to clear this wave right away, which gives first ban Cho'Gall the easy rotation right out the gate. That's pretty good. I don't think they were going to get that unless they did something cheeky and force out some cooldowns from Cho'Gall's Angels. Now look at this rotation. Now Diablo's going to be here. forcing them to be delayed. Would like to see somebody from Cho'Gall's end, or sorry, first man Cho'Gall come down to the bot side and pick up that set. Yeah. But yeah, early game, you know how it is. Clear waves, get camps out. Johanna, this is what I'm talking about. Johanna in the lanes can't really like control the Tri-Bush right now. Can't control the rotation, the wave clear at the beginning of the game. You kind of get set back. And I like this. I like that from first man Cho'Gall. They're not looking to take anything. They're just there just to show. Force a response. And if they see an opening, they'll take it. If not, that's fine. They keep doing their thing. Urel came down from the top side to clear that. That's a wave of soak that they're going to be missing. Not bad. But yep, clear waves, take camps. The eternal dance for the Shrine Suite. Lucy, though, getting really low, looking to walk the wrong way. You got the Hanzo confirming that last kill. Time, 1 HP, able to get back behind the fort wall. Heal up a bit. Brightwing should have phase shift by the time they respawn and come back in. Not bad. Not bad. A little overextended there. Now, Johanna is leaving. We see Kags. KJ getting the engage, but they weren't able to confirm that. Nice job from Balrog. Good job from the Hanzo there to find those kills. Johanna came down when she saw the engage happening and was able to help lock some of those people down as well. Really good opening right now. Way to come back here for Cho'Gall's Angels. They're going to get the first DK. Shows force the hearth back here. We're looking at a pre-3-minute DK. Excellent job. So during the Dragonite phase, if I'm not mistaken, I'm pretty sure these minions, some of these minions end up doing more damage. Maybe I'm mistaken here. But anyways, you want to use your minions, not during the Dragonite phase, but in general, the minions deal a lot of damage to structures. So ideally you want to take the Dragonite, get your wave pushing. Like, yeah, you can hit buildings with your Dragonite, but the minions are going to be dealing a lot of the damage to the buildings. So get your wave up there, create a nice push. We already see that bottom wall getting completely decimated here. We saw the engage on the smoke killer, but Anduin's going to be able to pull them away. Easy peasy. Level 7's online for Cho'Gall's Angels. Nice little first Dragonite phase. Not bad. Not bad. Life funnel. Okay. Seems some life funneling happening. Oh, Super just got chunked out so hard. Durkaduk once more. Can't find the kill with the double blinds. Nice flip on the Durkaduk under the fort. Gonna be able to walk away. Yo, the aggression. I like it. Hopefully they can keep their wave clear priorities up. I like that Tychus. Balrog has gone up mid to kind of help reset that lane. Gonna help the Sonya take this bruiser camp while all the lanes are reset. Really well done. That's nice. That's a nice play. Nice play. Something you can do with Tychus in your comps, if you draft a Tychus, you can use him to clear the lanes for your offlaner, kind of help them out, which we see a wave crashing here. It's going to end up going down. Traxxas should be able to pick it up. But you can have the Tychus pick up the side soak, and if anything, can also rotate up and harass the offlaner rotation, kind of keep them trapped up there. And you can force your opponent to have to give somebody else up to deal and weaken them elsewhere on the map. But, and the Tychus isn't the only hero you can do that with. Tychus just works well because he has a percentage-based damage and has decent enough wave clear. But you can do that. We see that happen with like Zeratul's, False Ads, and Thralls, Genji, etc. Nice little engage happening here. Time getting a bunch of resets. Showing his mechanical prowess on this hero. Level 10's about to hit though for Cho'Gall's Angels, so they gotta back up. They're not gonna find a whole lot there. Everyone's gotta go back to the lanes. Get their XP. And it looks like we're gonna see a rotation up here to the top side, potentially put some pressure on Traxxas Sonya. Nope, not quite. They're just gonna go back to the bottom side. I'd like to see time break off and get some of that side soak that I was talking about, that Tychus style. You can do that with the Mayev as well. Level 10's online. We got Leap, Odin, Falling Sword, Arrow, Light Bomb. Nice. I like this Falling Sword pickup for sure. Helps shut down a lot of the wombo combos. Engage there on the tracks. It's on the Sonya. We got the flip. We got the tether. Huge arrow coming in to peel the Falling Sword as well. Just to create some space. Oh, okay. The Leap was coming out. The Leap was coming out. Still got Apoc. We still got the Ardent Defender. A lot of cooldowns used. A lot of defensive cooldowns. Or cooldowns used defensively. From the side of Cho'Gall's Angels. We still got everything here. Oh, Apoc got used out here in the bot side. The Leap of Faith was used on Swarkiller to keep him alive. Time looking for something else. Don't think they're going to take that. Not quite. Oh, but Swarkiller caught between the wall and Diablo. That's not where you want to be. That feels bad, man. There's the Archon being popped. Just granted a little bit more sustain for Super. Putting out damage on the Balrog Show. On the top side, looking for the flank. Nice hop onto there. Gonna push Dirk the Jerk back into his team. Can they find a kill? The containment disc misses. He'll be able to walk away. Diablo, meanwhile, on the bot side, reclaiming control of the Moon Shrine. Show showing up here. Gonna try to get the wave so they can get their Sun Shrine for sure. But nice job. Both teams playing pretty well into each other. Really cool game. Really nice to see. Oh, there's a Leap and a big arrow tracks it. Setting that up and a huge follow-up coming up from Cho'Gall's Angels as they absolutely annihilate the four-man or first-man Cho'Gall. That was disgusting and very well executed. That was awesome. That was awesome. The complete confidence and just decisiveness that this team had to lock it in, make it happen. That was awesome. Oh, shit. This mid four is going to go down. They're like, we don't need a DK. We don't care about that. We'll get this without it. We're on our way out. That was so awesome. There was the Leap. There was... We're watching Cho'Gall's Angels execute their wombo combo team fight better than like 70% of the CCL teams. Okay? I'm just going to say it. It shouldn't be that free of a DK. Ooh, there's a nice little engage. Oh, the Apoc though. Oh, it timed perfectly, actually. But the defensive abilities from Cho'Gall's Angels keeping their teammates alive. Now here comes Dirk and Dirk on the backside, looking to harass just a bit. Nice force wall. The Iron Skin making sure that they don't get stunned. Life bomb and the Falling Sword on the back line. Here comes Traxxas looking for a Leap. Finds it onto the Brightwing, but I don't know if the damage is going to be enough there. Balrog trying to confirm the kill on the Diablo does. Nice job. Yo, let's go. Yo, Cho'Gall's Angels need to sign up for the Heroes International Qualifier. I'm just saying. Sign up. Get in there. Tether on the Swarkiller, though. There's a containment disc. You know what? I think that containment disc probably saved them. Yep. Bought some time for the Anduin to get there. Here comes Show looking to create space between him. Between Johanna and the rest of her team. He's going to be able to walk away. Still has the Ardent Defender. Oh, there it is. Gets popped, but Traxxas is waiting. Wants to find the kill. Is going to find it. Tychus, Hanzo, and Sonya all pumping the damage there onto the Urel. We see the beings coming out to take this bottom port. Opening up with the map. Yo, Cho'Gall's Angels are just utilizing their momentum very well. They know what they need to do, when they need to do it. They're doing it together as a unit. And they're finding a lot of value on the map, and they haven't gotten a DK. They don't care. They don't need it. They're just going to get the value that they can get. Better than what you see in other divisions. Look, that's all I'm saying. I've been watching a lot of HOTS for a long time, and this is really cool to see. Nice arrow. We got the Falling Sword as well. Fortunately, the Falling Sword didn't hit. That's okay. Force a little bit. Force some cooldowns there. You got to play a little slow. Now this combo is not that bad. It's a pretty high tempo combo. The longest cooldown that you need to wait on is what? 70 seconds, I think, on the Hanzo Dragon Arrow. Nice wall to be able to peel. Show. Get coming out here. Ooh, nice blind, actually, from Durka Durka. Make sure that tether didn't apply. Huge slow. There's a light bomb as well. They catch Maiev on the top side. Can they finish that kill? Looks like time's going to be able to get away. Face shift coming out. 8-bot combo onto Swarm Killer. Lives. Toasty Buns actually pogging. But here's Traxxas with a huge leap flank and just cleaning up the mess. Oh, my Lord. Who are these people? Let's go. Let's go. Top side. Shoving it down, getting a lot of value up there as well. And you know what? Look, they got the bot fort. They'll get this camp. They'll get top fort eventually. They'll get the DK as well. This is like peak value here. And they got the siege camp. Okay, peak value would have been you gotten this one too. But you know what? It's good. 99% effective. Nice job. What's up? Let's go. Huge wave on this bottom side, right? We got the minion wave. We got the siege giants, Dragonite, and a bruiser camp. On top of that, we're going to Odin is down. But we're here. We're looking. Containment this onto the DK. I don't think you can gauge under this, though. Falling swords back up. Arrows up. That's a spell power. That's a spell armor camp. They're going to slowly siege this up and put damage onto this keep. I will say, though, this is Hanzo in the DK. He needs to back up. I would have liked to see him back up just a little bit so you can throw an arrow here. We got a nice tether. Big arrow only hits the URL. Beautiful cleanse coming out from the Brightwing. But, oh, two members get stunned by the APOC. Johanna counter-engaging, though. Gets some cleanses. The life bombs doesn't land. Anduin ends up dying. But this is looking pretty rough here for Cho'Gall's Angels. They're really weak. They gotta have to retreat as much as possible, cut their losses. Smorkiller has to get out of here. There's no Ardent Defender. Needs to be careful. Show can actually die here. Oh, there's the kill. 3-for-2 trade. That's pretty good. This is good for first band Cho'Gall. They're able to come back into this game a little bit. So what I was saying over here, we had Hanzo on the fort in the Dragonite, and it was about to die. I'm like, yo, if you're Hanzo in this DK that's about to time out, you need to start walking back here and let your team control this space here. So when that engage does happen, or as your retreat starts to occur, you have the Dragon Arrow that's able to punish. Unfortunately, he wasn't back far enough. And when Cho'Gall, first man Cho'Gall did decide to engage, the arrow got like just the weakest stun that it could have possibly gotten. Couldn't set up for their engage. But not bad. Another chance to heal yourself. Do not squander it. This is a fun game. I'm really enjoying this one. Really awesome to see. Hey, Giant Slayer. We have Giant Slayer enjoyers in this lobby. That's really nice. You see the pings coming out here for the flank. They're holding that angle. They're looking for time. Nice lockdown. Put a lot of pressure onto the Maiev there. Yo. Let's go, Dive. Is this what every single one of your games look like out here? I'm about to start watching these games. Cast every single one of these. Ooh, APOC combo there. Onto Hanzo. Oh, the damage came out, though, a little too fast for the rest of the team to come out and be able to save. But there is no APOC combo. Great play from KJ. Heads up for sure. Very heads up play. Just ripping it. DK going over to the side of first band Cho'Gall. Let's see if they can get some value on this map. Open up the map for themselves a little bit. Create some opportunities for their team to get more on the map. Nice job on the Odin, using the Odin to defend this. This fort should be able to go down. Easy peasy, no big deal. Red team has destroyed a fort. DK's dying though. It is dying. We see the members. Cho'Gall's are, man, good boy. I told you I was gonna get messed up, man. First band Cho'Gall, they're gonna go up here to the top side. You know, if they're all gonna come up here, I wanna see them all push here as much as possible, you know. I almost would have liked to have seen the DK come up here as well. But all they're doing, I don't know, this feels like it was kind of a waste. Now they have to all hearth back and defend their keep. That beast is That didn't feel right. I like this. If you're Brian, we kind of just chill out. You wait, hide for a little bit. You can phase in. Oh, arrow got used. Oh, Toasty in the A-Pop combo. Needs to be careful. Oh, there's a Hellgate as well. Huge leap and falling sword. We got 20 second cooldown left on the falling sword. Pretty decent reset, but they're all going to have to back up here. It's going to be up very soon. The light bomb is up as well. Yo, that was close. That was very close. Arrow got used there a little early. I appreciate the look. Well done. Oh, Balrog does need to be careful, though. Needs to throw a grenade and dismount. There's going to be a tether onto the hero. Ooh, beautiful pull from Toasty Buns, keeping Tychus alive. Huge root as well. Oh, Diablo's so weak. Forced to walk away. Track sticks and show on the bot side looking for a duel. But that's an awesome light bomb. Falling sword combo on the top side. They find a kill on the Brightwing. Diablo's dead as well. This is going to be a complete and utter wipe in favor of Cho'Gall's Angels. Are going to get this bot keep. They're going to push all the way to the core and look to try to end this game. Yo, that was awesome. That was awesome. Beautiful play. Anduin doing a great job keeping the allies alive. And not only that, but got a really nice root. Got a nice little double root there as well. Put a lot of pressure onto the Diablo. I got to see some slams on this core. Let's see the slams. There's a leap as well on the time. The ping's coming out. Yo, hit the core. It's going to happen. Time's going to end up dying. Ladies and gentlemen, game number one. Going over to Cho'Gall's Angels. GG, well played. Hey. That was nice. That was very, very nice. Let's update these scores real quick. Cho'Gall's Angels taking game number one. Let's see. Take a look at some of these stats here. Point 1,000 experience soak from Traxxas. Did a really good job on Sonya. Understood what you needed to do. Looking for the wave clear, looking for wave prio, flanking gauges with the leaps, setting up those team fights with leap. One of the things that Johanna has a problem with is engaging, right, on a fairly consistent basis. People will pick Blessed Shield as a form of engage, and you can engage every 60 seconds. Well, what if you had somebody else on your team that can start the fights for you, and you can go Falling Sword to deal with whatever the opponent's throwing at you? You got the Sonya leap every 60 seconds, I think it is, or 70 seconds? 60. Arrow every 70 seconds. You follow that up with a Falling Sword if you need to, every 50. It's not bad. Well played there. Well played by both teams, but especially Cho'Gall's Angels. That was awesome. That was awesome. Waiting for this next lobby to get made here. Appreciate everybody for hanging out, being here, choosing to be here, choosing to spend your time here on a Tuesday evening. If you like what you see, you like what you hear, and you want to be a part of this, you want to be part of more, drop a follow. Also, I'm going to go ahead and shout out real quick Wild Heart Esports, wildheartesports.com. Go check us out. We recently placed second in CCL this past season for four seasons. We did pretty good, I like to think. Don't have a team competing at the Heroes International yet. I'm just going to say yet. But we'll see. We'll see if there's a team out there that grabs our attention and does well, and see what happens. But we'll definitely be there. I'll be there at the event in Miami in October. Next qualifier is September, the weekend of like September 10th or something like that. So go ahead and check it out. Join the NGS Discord. Sign up. All the information is going to be there. Follow at @heroes_inter on Twitter as well. I cast from time to time Jazzy. I like to cast with Jazzy, Jazzeline. She does a lot of the casting as well, Storm Div and for that Heroes International. So game number two is gonna be on Garden of Terror. This is a Cho'Gall's Angels map pick. So we're going to the Garden of Terror. I wonder if we'll see similar things happening on this map as we did on that previous one. Kind of insane, huh? Alright, let's get into this draft. Ladies and gentlemen, game number two between Cho'Gall's Angels and first band Cho'Gall. Well, one team's a Cho'Gall enthusiast, the other's not. Man, that game number one was awesome. That game number one was like crazy. The Wombos, it was like just great execution from Cho'Gall's Angels. You know, I don't want to take anything away from first band Cho'Gall, but I really want to gas up Cho'Gall's Angels for sure. That's the kind of stuff that, like, man, you wish you could see more often. Mwah, a work of art. It was amazing. We got the first band Cho'Gall coming out, as well as the first band Blaze. No Blaze. What's the second man gonna be here? I wonder if it'll be Johanna. Yeah, it's gonna be the Johanna. Removing that from the table. And then there's gonna be the Lucio ban as well. So now, what are first band Cho'Gall gonna pick? They want to Diablo and Brightwing into the first pick, Johanna. So we'll see what ends up happening. It's gonna be a Dahaka. So with the off lane kind of being just a little bit limited with the Blaze being removed. Hogger is still up. They opt to go with the Haka. So I wonder they do first ban Hogger, first ban Cho'Gall. They will ban Hogger. So that leads me to believe that there's nobody on their team that plays him. We got a Diablo Tychus here. Okay. I think that's okay. I get it. You know, you want to remove the Tychus or the Diablo, a good tool into Diablo. But I don't know if Diablo and Tychus can pair. Like, I don't think it's the most optimal pairing. But I get it. You want to deny it. For first band Cho'Gall, you can probably work around this a little bit with some of your hero options. They're going to be playing for the map. They're going to double down on the map and on what the map likes. Wave clear, camp clear, sieging, all that stuff. You got the global, the wave clear with the Dahaka. You've got Greyman and Rhaegar that can wave clear and take camps and push. This is a fairly decent opener here. They're looking to play a pretty macro focused style. And with Diablo Tychus, you're kind of limited right now on what you can do for wave clear. Ooh, they banned the Uther. They've been doing their homework, trying to disable that double support. I think it's Super that plays. Is it KJ? Maybe it was KJ that played the Uther. I can't remember. The Hanzo. They didn't like the arrows. And you know what? Hanzo and the Diablo together, not terrible. You got some pretty good wombo combo potential. And Hanzo kind of helps with the camps. There's a Brightwing and the Deathwing. We got the two lizards coming out here. Two dragons. I know Track 6 loves to play Deathwing. I'm going to be curious to see how that plays out. these last two picks coming out. This is going to be a Genji and a Muradin. Okay. I don't know how I feel about the Genji, especially with Brightwing, Diablo. I mean, just for what's being shown right now, I'm not a fan of the Genji. I think you probably just could have ran my Ev again. You can containment disc the Deathwing. It's a big target that you can put a lot of damage into. It's going to be a Gul'dan, and it gives you just more engage opportunity. If that's what you were going to do, you know, you can run to my Ev again. I don't know. But the Gul'dan coming out, decent wave clear. Pretty good wave clear, actually. Horrify is a hell of a tool, hell of a heroic. That being said, fairly low mobility hero. That Genji, Greymane, Muradin, potentially the Dahaka with the burrow, with the dig on the backside, can look to punish that. You know, they do have Horrify to potentially keep themselves safe. But with the Brightwing sustain, it can get a little weird. However, there are builds available that where Gul'dan can keep themselves alive. We got a bunch of Angels fans in the chat. Okay. All right. We're rooting for the Cho'Gall team? All right, bet. The Cho'Gall team is going to win. Is this going to be... I hope this isn't a W build. This is not a W build, Gul'dan. I mean, it could be okay. No, I've seen it pop off sometimes. But I just feel like there's this Muradin is going to make that very difficult. Especially as they go Skullcracker, right? And going to be stationary, looking to get beat. You could be baiting, though, I guess. You're sucking, and then Brightwing throws a spell shield on top of you to tank some of that damage. It's gonna be the suck build. Okay, you know what? Prove me wrong. I want to see it happen. It's game number two, ladies and gentlemen. We got Cho'Gall's Angels leading the series 1-0. Yo, you know what? Lucy always goes W build. Always goes W build on Red Dawn. Always. I'm not sure why. I'm not sure why they do that. Probably gonna force a response from the rest. They're gonna maybe just push mid out a little bit. You know how it goes, ladies and gentlemen. First couple minute or so of the map, it's just clear waves, trying to get some advantages, take the camps. You know, this matchup up here a little interesting. Oh, KJ. Beautiful play there from Durka Dirk. Nice job. That was really clean. I really appreciate that. Nice job. They almost get the kill on the Muradin. However, was able to walk away. So he walked up here. We got the stun, and then he walked back over on this side because he knew Muradin was going to keep walking this way and flipped him back over. That was really nice. And then there was a polymath on top of that. I do like this invade, though, coming out. This invade is really nice. They've been just playing the map. They've been in the jungle. They've been taking the camps. The lanes are getting soaked. Nice. That's going to deal some damage there for sure. Psychic's going to have to go deal with that. I'm here for NA's number one death ring. Okay. Getting blessed by the gods that are Cho and Gall. My voice volume just a smidgen lowish. All right, hopefully that's okay right there. Hopefully it's a little bit better. Because I feel like my microphone is at its peak. I could probably turn the game volume down a little bit, but up here on the top side, we got that siege coming out. Traxxas took a lot of damage from the Muradin and the Greymane. I do like the siege up here, especially with the Bruiser Camp. You got the spell armor to kind of act as the shield, augment your push. You got big, thick minions that can tank the towers while you get the damage done. This is beautiful. I love it. Oh, there's an even engage on the Traxxas. Can they finish it off? They should be able to. Nice job. diving, tower diving. This guy's been playing League of Legends. Not bad. They're going to get a fort. Hey, a fort for a tribute for one stack? Not, oh, they're just going to give it up. They don't want to get stalled out. Oh, it's... Oh, wow. No one's going for it. No one's going for it. I mean, I don't know. I think this favors first band Cho'Gall more so than it does Cho'Gall's Angels. They want to try to get that or get some of their own value, but it's going to be difficult. You don't have the same kind of map control, map presence as first band Cho'Gall does. The Greymane, the Rhaegar, the Muradin, the Dahaka, that's a lot of map presence. Hell, even the Genji at this point. It's not bad. Just being annoying. But yeah, they do all that, and they get the tribute. They get the first seed. Nice. It's better? All right, appreciate it. Thank you, Tazik. Drag there on the Diablo. Can they get away? Don't think they're going to be able to find that kill. Ooh, KJ, though. Barely walking out of there. Track 6 is pogging up here with that soak. Smart killer, though, ends up going down. Nice, beautiful wall bang. There's a polymorph as well, and that's going to be a dead Greymane. Two kills to one so far. I like what Track 6 did there. You know, like, hey, I'm just going to keep getting value up here. It doesn't matter. Showing her prowess on that hero. I almost want to say champ. I wonder if we'll see a similar setup from first band Cho'Gall. If they'll forego that objective since it is on the opponent's side and siege at bottom. I mean, with the Genji and with the Muradin, you can look to stall out the objective while Greymane and Rhaegar go down and siege. I would like to see that, actually. I would like to see that. Looks like they're just going to clear. Level 10's online. Pretty nice. Pretty nice here for first band Cho'Gall. Extract Ancestral. There's a Cursed Bullet. Oh, KJ has the Dwarf toss away. Oh, the Cursed Bullet and the Burrow. The Dig coming out from Sho to find the pick onto the Tychus. They get that kill. Oh. The Cataclysm had to be used there. I don't know if Trax is going to be able to get away. Genji super sitting on there. Gets that kill. Ancestral being popped. They're looking for more. Oh, beautiful. Five-man Horrify there. There's an Apoc as well. Super. Oh, doesn't get caught in the Apoc. But Sho's going to die to the fort. Executed. Nice job. That was sick. That Horrify was clean. They could have gotten a couple extra kills there. Or a kill, another kill. But didn't work out. They're going to get the second tribute. Or the second seed. Meanwhile, these lanes. A little in favor for first band Cho'Gall. We had to pause there. Should be ready to go. Any countdowners? Any readiers, I should say. Hi, how you guys doing, chat? You guys doing all right? What you guys got going on this week? Anyone going to anyone watch any cool movies? Anyone watching Game of Thrones? Let me know how that's going. Is it good? Is it must-see TV? Bellowing Roar, Odin, Apocalypse. Pretty cool. Oh, and we're seeing the cocktail build again. From time. Okay. Alright, this one's in the middle here. Both teams probably gonna make a play for this. Now, if you are, if you are Cho'Gall's Angels maybe look to get some wave priority here and threaten this bottom four to give yourself an advantage to get this seed. I don't like it when people just rip bruiser camps and don't push with it. You gotta push with it. Like, it's the bruiser camp is so powerful, especially on this map. If you can get forts structures without having the need to use the objective, it's way better. Now look at this. Like, this is gonna get cleared up for free, and you're not gonna have time to channel this. So now your enemy team is gonna show up here and be annoying as hell. And yeah. And now they got a siege camp pushing. Like I said, you should have pushed with that. Threaten this a little bit. Apoc combo coming out on the time. They find the stun there. Beautiful cleanse coming out. Unfortunately, there's no ancestral follow-up. It was a great horrify. The cleanse was nice. Great job from Traxxas to come down. We got the Commodore Odin being popped, and they're going to siege up the spot four. Okay. Hey, look. We didn't push with the camp, but we found the initiation. We found the engage. We're going to get the fort now. That was well done there by Durka Durk. You know what? Big, huge respect to Durka Durk for just realizing what needed to be done. They got the kill. Now they get the objective. They got the fort as well. That was really well played. Man, I'm really impressed with a lot of these players and a lot of these teams, these two teams in this division. It's awesome to see. That being said, you know, they're all behind a little bit in XP. So there was a situation earlier in Storm Division. One team had a pretty significantly powerful team fight composition, a comp that could find the kills. Unfortunately, they couldn't siege. They couldn't get value on the map. There's strong kill potential coming out here from the side of Cho'Gall's Angels. I've yet to see them be able to siege up and get value on the map with their comp. Let's see if we can start seeing some of that. I would like to be able to see that happen without the objective needing to be there and without you having to pop Odin and all this other stuff. You're not going to give it a chance? Okay. Oh, Traxxas getting collapsed on up here on the top side. Oh, the cursed bullet doesn't land, but there's going to be a huge wraparound. Nice cleanse. Sweet Lucy playing that so well. The horrified follow-up as well. We got the phase shift happening on the S'more Killer. Who's going to be able to tank through all of this? Sweet Lucy's caught between a rock and a hard place. Auto attack, Bill Diablo doing the thing. The ancestral healing, looking to keep him alive. S'more Killer able to tank through so much. Is there going to be a storm bolt? It doesn't land. Beautiful peel coming out from Durka Durk, who's going to continue to just create the space. S'more Killer goes down. Time, though, very low. Forced to jump away. I wonder if Cho'Gall's Angels can find a little bit more here. They're looking. Oh, I think did they stop the Dwarf Toss? No, there's the Dwarf Toss right there. Balrog on the other side. Gonna try to run the Muradin down. Any Storm Bolters? It's not going to happen. He's going to go down. And that's a one-for-one even trade for both sides. Can we get the value? Can we get the seed? Not quite. There's going to be a flip, a charge there onto Dahaka. Toasty Buns looking to peel for Traxxas, but Traxxas is just committing. She's in there. There's going to be a Cataclysm, but I don't think she's... Oh, she gets away! Actually insane! Oh my god! That was like sub 20. Now Diablo's going to end up going down. No mana, no sustain. Oh, the X-Strike doesn't land. Wait a second. You gotta be able to get away. No, Rhaegar should be able to chase this down. As will Toasty. Oh, Toasty Buns goes down. Diablo goes down. And it looked like a trade, but now it's not. Now it's not. Full level lead here for the side of First Band Cho'Gall. They're gonna go ahead and pause. They lost somebody. But this is gonna be their second seed, their second objective. Still anybody's game. Unlucky. Terrible internet. Unlucky. The Canadian internet or something. I think this happened the last time they played. Let's take a look at the map here. Top Ford is down, bottom Ford is down. This wave, Track 6 is doing a good job keeping these lanes pushed out. Murden is going to come down here to soak this up, but won't be there in time. It's going to take forever to clear this wave up and then rotate back up here on this side. Track 6 should be able to just go back into the air, heal, and then drop down when needed. Looks like they're probably going to make a play for this bruiser camp and let that go over here. But, but yeah. Let's go ahead and come back over here to this screen though. Just in case, I'm going to hide the map a little bit. Oh, they're ready. Never mind. Let's get back into it. Blue, you ready? Whenever Blue's ready. All right, there we go. Man, pretty tight game so far. Pretty even. One more stack left on the cocktail and the incendiary elixir. Now, I wonder if... I guess Executioner's not bad here. You got the... I mean... Murden slows and stuns, sure. Oh, there's... Hang on. It'll be alright. The totem from Rhaegar. Now, it's not as effective. It's not as effective as... it could be, because it's not that build. But, not the totem build, but whatever. I wonder if the Alpha Wolf could be pretty good. Executioner's probably your safest bet. Both teams taking it easy, taking their time. This seed, very, very favorable. Very favorable here for the side of, well, it's on Cho'Gall's Angel's side. Oh, 8-ball combo coming out there under the Murden. They find the stuns. There's a kill. There's no Ancestral, no cleanse available. Beautiful. Beautiful job there from Durkadurk again. Just showcasing dominance from his tank position. Just showing sheer just decisiveness. It's so good. I love that's so awesome. Love to see that. And the team ready to go. Follow up right behind that. Garden Terror phase coming out here. Cho'Gall's Angels. Let's see how much damage they can get done here. Odin's being popped. Looks like they're all gonna stack up here on the mid side. Nice. We got the polymorph onto the Genji. Oh wow! The X-Strike coming out at the same time as Horrify. Both of these players, Smort Killer and Super, are gamers. They were able to just play off each other like that. That was awesome. Nicely done. Polymorph as well. Oh, the charge, flip, poly, Ancestral. Not able to go off and keep the Genji alive. Oh, the stun out, the Dwarf Toss. This is going to be a dead Murden as well. This is two kills. This is looking... absolutely amazing for Cho'Gall's Angels. They're looking. If they can get this keep down, maybe find another pick, they can look to end this game. They're looking. They got to hit the keep. They're going. There go the pings. Pings on the core. They're stacking up. Putting the damage out. They're going all in. Smort Killer gets dragged. That's a big part of their siege damage. They got to reset. They got to back up, and it's a long way home. There's a Cataclysm there to cover the retreat path all the way out. Nice job. Nice job from Cho. Finding the drag there onto the Gul'dan. Finding the pick, capitalizing, and hey, giving their team another shot to stay in this game. Yo. What a series. (Clears late game shenanigans. I say late game. Both teams are level 20, level 15 happened, you know, or 15 minutes into this game. This is cursed, hollow. Oh my god. This is Garden of Terror. It's a cursed map. You know, I've got PTSD from this map. We don't talk about the Winians. But this is one of those maps where, like, hey, you know, you spent all that time collecting those seeds. You got some pretty good value on the map, but, like, how long is it going to take before you can actually end this game, right? It's level 19 to level 20. Enemy team got a lot of XP from all the waves that have been crashing, all the camps and stuff. This is really good for them. They're going to get a big advantage here because of these waves. They're pushing the bot side as well. Okay, so here's the thing. Cho'Gall's Angels has to rotate to prevent this curse from happening. That's what they're telling themselves. First ban Cho'Gall saying, hey, it's okay. They can take that if they want to. We're just going to siege up. We can give this up. We don't need this tribute. We don't need this siege. Oop. So now you force a response. You got the Odin being popped here. Keep wall ends up going down. A little bit HP left on that turret. But and then now look at this. Now you can come back up here. Here's Dehaka. Now he can play for the seed. Can he get it? No, he can't. Forced to use the essence. Oh, KJ needs to be careful. There's a stun. Nice. Oh, Traxxas in the air. Oh my god. Where's it at? The meteors? Yep, with the where's that at? Oh, it's this one. Arrival of a god. Oh, APOC combo. Beautiful cleanse, though. There's APOC. It does get used. There's a horrify as well. There should be able to pop. Oh, there's the ancestral. Nice. They get the dragon, the storm killer. They get storm killer. They're down. Sweet Lucy stays alive. Beautiful bellowing roar. Peeling for the rest of the team. Can they find some more? If they find more, they can look to end the game potentially. That's a dead Brightwing. Oh, they're going to find more. Balrog goes down as well. Oh my god, three members. Actually, I don't know if they can end the game. They got a lot of structures to go through. They're going to prioritize this top side. They're all up here already. We see the inner beast being popped. Oh man, this is 45 seconds before Tychus is up. 26 for Gul'dan. They're going to chew through this keep really quick before the Garden Terror gets there. Oh, and Deathwing is in the air as well. Oh, they're posturing. They're looking for the core. Yeah, okay. They're going to try to do it. Oh, Traxxas throwing out some stun. The Polymorph is actually kind of pogging here. It's pogging. It's doing its thing. Here comes Gul'dan. The core is falling down. 60%. Do we get the Horrify? Is it happening? Oh, there it is. Huge bellowing roar, actually. But it's not going to matter. All the damage is going to come out there at the end. GG, well played. Game number two. Going over to the side of first ban Cho'Gall's. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going all the way. We're going the distance. Game number three. Yo, this has been a very fun game to watch. And I'm glad that you guys are here to watch this. This is insane. Hell yeah. Let's take a look at the stats here real quick. Triple sevens. That's the second time I see that today. Hey, should probably go play, go get a scratcher. Well done. We saw, hey, this is valiantly fought here by Cho'Gall's Angels. We did see that first band Cho'Gall were able to kind of play the map a little bit better. I think it looked they were able to do so. Able to take camps quicker, clear the waves faster, siege up the buildings better. Well done. And that was a Cho'Gall's Angels map pick. That was their map pick. All right. Appreciate you, Duke. I'm out of practice. Ooh, yo. Hey, game number three. Oh, let me update the score real quick. Game number three. Chat, where do you guys want to go? What do you guys want to see? You let me know what you guys want to see. I'm going to let you know if you're right. Once again, thank you all for hanging out here, for being here. Appreciate every single one of you who choose to be here on a Tuesday evening. Make sure you guys follow NGS. Hop in the Discord. Matcherino. I got to get those commands set up. There's a Matcherino there as well. You can donate to the prize pool for Storm Division, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah. What else? What else is going on? Heroes International Qualifiers happening September 10th. A second one with the final, final qualifier, last chance qualifier happening sometime after that, if I'm not mistaken. Like the week after. You want Braxis? Not quite. Game number 3. Not Braxis. But yeah. Tomorrow, I will be casting with the Crushinator on his channel. I'm going to be watching, we're going to be casting the Wild Heart Zetas, which is our academy team. They are playing in the Heroic Division. Is it Nexus or Heroic? I think it's Nexus. Can't remember. I get those two confused. They are playing tomorrow night. So come out, support Wild Heart. We still out there doing hot stuff, 100%. WildHeartEsports.com. Go check it out. Got some fabulous merch that we dropped as well. Join the Discord if you like to play other games, like to talk about other games.
Towers of Doom.
There you go. That's what it is right there. That's what it is right there. Towers of Doom, ladies and gentlemen. But yeah, if you like to play other games, like to talk about other games, life, IRL, whatever. Come hang out. Good community there. Lots of cool people. Today I was talking. It's all. You can go in there and take a look. People play League, people play Rocket League, people play whatever, HOTS, all kinds of stuff. We talk IRL stuff, talk about life. I had a pretty interesting conversation, you know, just a little chat with somebody in there about like the Bible, for example. It was just cool. Cool, everyone's civil, you know. Video game, Elden Ring, any Elden Ringers out there? If you're an Elden Ring connoisseur, please, by all means, let me know. Let's link up. We got a new game, 7 it up. We gotta run some of these bosses. Kicking my ass. Anyways. Same bands that we saw last game, except for it's a Gaul this time, it's not a Cho. Oh, the first pick, Diablo, right out the gate. Towers of Doom. KJ, gonna show Durka Dirk what's up. Like, yo, hey, you think you know how to play that hero? Let me show you what I got. Anduin getting picked up again by Toasty Buns. Toasty did a really good job on Dragonshire with that Anduin. And the Tychus. So you got two heroes that can deal with a Diablo pretty decently. If you are first man Cho'Gall, you can double down on this. You could potentially look to be more aggressive and jump onto this Anduin even more. Anduin can save a lot of people, but can't save himself. And you got to put that pressure on the Anduin. You got to get back there and spook him. I don't know if Li Ming is the answer to that. We'll see. If they can blow somebody up fast enough on the before the Anduin pool comes out, cool. We'll see. Got the Brightwing being removed. I think you want some Peel to be removed if you are. You want to remove some Peel heroes. Anubarak. Okay. I mean, you have an Anubarak cocoon counter with the Li Ming, I guess. But. Sure, get rid of it. Huh. Oh my god.
Redemption.
Yo, that murky skin actually goes kind of hard though. I like the orange. Yo, Track 6 said, I don't care if you got a Dehaka, Diablo, or a Li Ming, I'm picking this hero. There's the Uther, and then there's a Genji. Ooh, okay. Yo, they're going hard. They're going in. They want to end this game quick. They want the fights to start and end just like that. If they can find the initial reset on the Murky, it could snowball out of control. What's this last pick going to be here from Dirk Dirk? Stitches. Stitches the flea bag. Just gonna take a lot of damage, maybe. Maybe remove a hero from a fight. Yo, there are a lot of squishy. I'm just gonna be real with you though. There's a lot of squishy heroes here on the side of Cho'Gall's Angels, and there's a lot of heroes on the other side that love squishy heroes. Alright. That being said. They're wave clear. First band Cho'Gall's wave clear. Pretty booty butt cheeks. As a matter of fact, it's not booty butt cheeks. It's like, yeah, it's poopy booty butt cheeks. Enemy minions are going to be healing from how bad their wave clear is. All right. But we'll see. Once those fights start happening. Once those fights start happening, what that looks like? This is it, ladies and gentlemen, game number 3. We'll find out who the winner is of this brutal. This has been a brawl, very competitive match. Glad to see you guys are here. Good luck with your internet connection. Is being called. All right. Angels got this. Okay. Oh. That was cool. Unfortunately, Stitch is able to walk away, not take any damage. Didn't take any damage, but there's no pull here. There we go. Nice. All right. There's no pull. I like that. I like that. There was no pull. They know that. Cooldowns are short enough to where they can go back in and engage. They don't need to wait on ults or nothing. They just press Q, E, and like that's it. So not bad. Oh. The execution. Oh, here comes a dig from the Dehaka. He's here. He's here for business. They got the drag on the Tychus. Where's the shadow charge? Is it coming out? There it is. Flip as well. That's going to be a dead Tychus. Oh, that's another kill. Two kills right now. 2.5 in favor of first man Cho'Gall. They get that camp too. They're going to be able to get theirs out as well if they want. Damn. True, they gotta play. They gotta avoid any kind of confrontation for sure. It's gonna be tough though. Track 6 can't even get the bribe stacks off all the way. I think it's gonna be the first full wave that she's able to get. There we go. Nice job. Oh, KJ taking a lot of damage there. Forced to use a soul shield, but it's Diablo, pretty tanky hero. Once the minion gun wears off, there's not gonna be a whole lot of follow-up damage that puts him into any danger. That is until Smart Killer gets Giant Slayer. This camp's still not out yet. Light bomb murky? I don't know. Here comes time. Nice engage there onto the Hanzo. No pull. There's a pull right there. But here comes the drag. Cho looking for something. Finds the Tychus. There's no drag available here. Nice CC chain. They get the kill onto the Tychus. Oh, yo, these digs from Cho have been very nice. Very nice. They're going all in. They're going all in. Can they find this kill? I don't know if they'll find the kill. Beautiful bloody body blocks. KJ actually body blocking out of his mind. And they get that kill onto the Stitches. Yo, they came to play. They ready. They said, we're not dropping game two or game three. Cho'Gall's Angels got to play it slow. Take their time. Yo, this murky skin is, it goes so hard. I like it. It's like a little Nemo skin. Oh, there's a drag there. No fruit follow-up. But they're going to pump out some damage. They got to be careful, though. Because there's going to be the re-engage coming out from the Diablo. He's walking away. No social. He should die here. He should die. There it is. Last auto attack there to confirm the kill. And that actually resets Diablo's souls. Oh, the hook! The swift strike got canceled. So Diablo died losing all the souls before level 10. So now has to start over from zero. That sucks. That feels bad, man. There's a hook there on the Uther. Gotta be careful. Counter engage coming out from Diablo. Uther follow up as well. Pull. Not able to come out in time. That's going to be a dead Hanzo. They got to be careful. They got to keep maintain their distance. The invade here. Oh, hook. Nobody in that bush. Later on, they'll catch the person in the next bush. There's the boss spawning on the map. 5 minutes. It looks like both of these altars are just going to go over to the side of first band Cho'Gall. And they're just going to look to open up the bottom side of the map and get some damage done out here. Their siege damage is pretty low, right? Pretty low. Took them all that time to get two towers. So, but they got some XP. They recouped some lost XP. This is Towers of Doom. It ain't over until it's over, right? So, nice hook there on the KJ. All the damage is coming out, but here comes Genji on the flank. Put some damage out. Oh! Smork Killer took a huge amount of damage from the Li Ming. The drag missed. And it ended up going down the body blocks of death coming out here on the Dirk and Dirk. And that's a dead Stitches, 100%. Wow. Yo, the first band Cho'Gall, they are out here. They're able to kill their targets before the Anduin pool comes out. And then later on, what's going to happen? What's going to be your save tool? The light bomb? I don't know. We'll see. It's going to be tough. But here we go. Level 10's online for both teams. We got light bomb, dragon arrow. We got Gorge, Odin, and Octograb. D-Shield. Apocalypse. We got the Wave of Force. Dragon Blade. And Adaptation. Interesting. Adaptation, huh? Nice hook there. Here comes Time on the backside. Looking to create a little bit of pressure. Nice root there. There's a D-Shield and a Dragon Blade. He's going in deep. He's going in deep. But there's going to be a Gorge. There's a Gorge right there. Huge arrow to peel away the rest of the team. Light Bomb coming out. Oh, a little too early. Ends up going down. But that's going to be two members. Sweet Lucy went in. Just said, yo, Genji, I know you're going to die, but take me with you, please. Just send me all the way back home. Yo, nice job there. Nice job there from the side of Cho'Gall's Angels. They got to get that timing down just a little bit better. They're going to siege up here on the bot side. It's only one altar. They'll get the four, get themselves five shots, come back into the game. We saw Murky taking this camp here. Can they get the fort before the sappers hit? Don't think that's gonna be the case. Yeah, they'll get it. Yeah. Hog. Potential for eight shots to go into the core here. There's a hook there on the time. Oh, he got rooted as well. Forced the swift strike away. Nice wave of force to create the space. Nobody wants to get flipped by Diablo. If so, that is their death sentence. All right, none of those sappers are going to go in. Hook onto the Uther. There's a stun. Dirk a Dirk, buying time, just waiting. Big waves crashing mid here. Gonna create. If this keeps happening, there's gonna be a lot of pressure, a lot of chip damage done to these forts. Where first band Cho'Gall's gonna be able to get back into it. Oh, there's the pull, there's the arrow. No gorge though. Kill there onto the murky wallbang onto Tychus. Nice gorge underneath the fort. There's gonna be a D shield here on top of this though. There's a cleanse, no D shield required just yet. Oh, there's a drag and an APOC combo onto the Hanzo who gets deleted. There's a dragon blade D shield, a classic coming out there together. Oh my lord, they're gonna look to reset on everything here. That's three members going down. Can they get the fourth? They will. This is going to be four members and the fort down. And now on top of that, they'll get the objective. Wow. Beautifully played there by first band Cho'Gall. There was a drag. There was an APOC right after. They got the Hanzo. That dig into this bush. Everyone forgets about this bush. It's so good. It's so powerful. Dang. 31 shots to 24.
And put an end to the Gravekeeper.
Four shots going out there. Alright. Just a level lead. This is the best time right here. The best time for Cho'Gall's Angels to get back into this game and create pretty significant advantage. This is it. Before level 16's hit, they gotta find a hook somewhere. They gotta find a pick onto somebody. But it's tough. Can they? They're not gonna force the gorge here. There's an arrow as well. There's a light bomb. Beautiful cleanse. There's no D shield. They find a pick there on the Diablo. Now they gorge. Oh, they octo grab the Haka. They gorge the Uther on this bot side. They'll Balrog take a lot of damage there from the lead main. There's a little battle happening there. Where's the drag? Do we see the drag here on the stitches? None yet. Adaptation being popped. The body block was so nice. Can they get the kill? Nope, gonna be able to walk away. Genji though, looking on the backside. They're just looking for more. There's the minigun being used on the Diablo. APOC being used as well. There's a D shield, but Balrog kind of stepping out a little too far. Nice stun to be able to stop the overkill. Li Ming ends up going down. I thought the Swiss strike was gonna come out. But it didn't. That was back and forth, back and forth. There we go. They got themselves back into the game, though. Level 16. Level 16. Really cool. Steady blade. Oh, my God. All right. Let's go. This top fort ends up going down. Nice job there from TraxX. Creating pressure on that map. Murky value. Like, hey, this game's not over. They're going to look to convert this bottom side. I don't know if it's worth giving up all these shots, though. Well, you know what? It's not gonna matter. It's gonna be four shots total, right? Nope, it'll be five. It'll be five shots total, so there's a lot of work that they have to do to get these buildings back. Their siege damage is pretty bad. It's Li Ming and it's Genji. So there's a lot of time that Cho'Gall's Angels have to play with. They can look to get a lot of value done on this, a lot of value on the map here. Maybe they can look to 6 cap at some point. Oh, there's the pull there onto the stitches. Oh, the drag. Nope, not quite. Oh, they're all five members are down here to try to deal with this. Big arrow, it doesn't miss. That's an E-useless arrow. E-useless. Oh my lord, everything's being popped here. TraxX slowly chipping away here. Driving them mad. But they're gonna get these back. They capped all those structures before the objectives came up, so it would have been nice to see 12 shots have gone out earlier, but could have been 10.
At least.
But yeah, they get top four back. Oh, they find a Diablo. Nice double root there. Be careful, APOC combo coming out of the smart killer. Where's the pull? It's not there. It's not available, unfortunately. You gotta watch out with those engages. It's tough. There goes Dirk and Dirk. There's the Octograb as well, but it's not gonna matter. That's a kill onto the Murky, and this is the worst possible time for that to happen. Double alter phase. Now, that being said, not enough shots right now for a loss, for the win. They get six shots here. Could have been a lot worse. I guess it could have been a lot worse. But that was not. That was definitely not ideal. Didn't want that happening. 25 shots to 9. So we're seeing Cho'Gall's Angels. They have a lot of momentum. Things are looking good. But right away, as soon as the opportunity presents itself, KJ Cads on the Diablo, punishing anyone's positioning. On top of that, the rest of his team is able to follow up it just right away, find those kills. It's disgusting. They're gonna be level 20. This is rough. Another double alter phase, and the boss is up. I think if you're first man Cho'Gall, you play for the boss. Now, if you can find picks, if you're being aggressive. Oh, nice wave of force to get the wall bang there on the stitches. There's the Tychus. Oh, nice pull on the Diablo. They're looking. The Hellgate was used. Nice little hook there back onto the Genji. Oh my god, the AoE D shield. They blow up the Murky. And they keep walking forward. Arrow did go down. Didn't hit anything. I'm pretty sure the AoE D shield just went right through them. That was disgusting. Double alter phase. This is going to be 8 shots and then the boss. What do you do here if you're Cho'Gall's Angels? You know what you do? You not lose. That's what needs to happen. You cannot lose here. Oh, can they find it? No, they're not going to be able to get away. Dirk and Dirk ends up going down. Oh, the Dragon Becomes Me is fragging. There's a wall bang there onto the Titans. They're going to find the kill on the Balrog. They're going to get the Ford as well. Ooh, nice. APOC there. The Wave of Force almost pushing him back into the APOC. There's a Swift Strike happening on the Toasty Buns. Going to be able to get away. Traxxas trying to be sneaky back here and buy some time for her team, but doesn't look like it's gonna happen. Oh, that's a dead Hanzo. There you go. They're going to go up for the boss. There's a reset. GG's being called. Oh, that's it. They got the bottom four. Yep, they got the bottom four. GG's, well played. Wow. That was it. That was close. Not going to lie. Cho'Gall's Angels almost had it. Just some mispositioning, you know, and then unfortunate timing, not being more aware that the objectives were going to spawn and things like that. But yeah. First man, Cho'Gall taking the dub in his best of 3. Let's see if we can find an interview here real quick with one of the guys from Let me see if they're about it, man. Yeah, GG, well played. Both teams did a fantastic job. That was a very entertaining game. Absolutely. I would like to see. I definitely like to see these teams come out for the Heroes International qualifier. Come out, show everybody what they got. You know, that'd be sick. Still waiting on a response. Not sure if we'll get one. But yeah, everybody, thanks for coming out. Appreciate you, every single one of you. You guys are awesome. Yeah, we're not going to do it. No interview, I guess. Unlucky, but that's okay, though. That's okay. Let me go ahead and come back here. Come back to me here. Thanks everybody for coming out. Appreciate you guys 100%. That was a fantastic series. Division A East. Hey, are all the games like this? Somebody let me know if they're all like this. If they are, I'm about to cast every single game, dude. I'm about to cast every single game. Nah, but that was awesome. Shout out NGS. Thanks for letting me cast. Crushing it. Appreciate you, man. Thanks for letting me, thanks for trusting me to cast. tomorrow, gonna be casting with the Crushinator, Wild Heart Zetas. That's gonna be over on his channel. That's gonna be a fun game. And then shout out to Wild Heart, obviously. That's my org. A lot of cool stuff happening. Follow us on Twitter at Wild Heart Esport. Follow the stream here. I've got a YouTube. You can go catch the VOD here on YouTube. Goon GGWP on Twitter at Goon GGWP. On Instagram, GoonGGWP. Tell your friends, if you enjoyed this cast, if you enjoy hanging out here, you enjoy the vibes, let them know. This is where it's at. This is where it's going to be. Shout out to my partner, Jazzeline, my other casting partner as well. She's out there. We're going to be casting the Heroes International qualifiers as well. So be on the lookout for those things. And let's see what's going on here. Let's see. What's the temp out in Flagstaff? So, hey, yo, I'm not in Flagstaff anymore, actually. I am in Alabama. I'm in Alabama, and it's a nice, humid 90 degrees. It sucks. Oh, man. But all right, guys. Hey, thank you so much. Actually, I'm going to... Oh, there's an... Oh, okay, there is interview. Cool. We're gonna get you an interview right now. Oh, this happened last year, man. Last year. All right, here we go. Hello, hello.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good, thank you. How's things with you?
Pretty good. Good games. That was fun. That was a fun series
thank
to
you.
Watch. Hopefully it was just as fun to play in.
Oh, it was great. Yeah, honestly, we were just having a blast.
Awesome. So tell me a little bit about your team. The first time I saw you guys was in the Heroes International Qualifier. You guys went up against 30K, and that was a very fun series to watch as well. It was refreshing. I'll just say it like that. I saw y'all were playing tonight, and I was like, hey, let me go give it a look. Let's go see what's going on. But yeah, tell me a little bit about your team. What's the story here?
So we've been together for quite a long time, actually, within like our kind of like not we don't it's not like an org or anything, but you know, we've been kind of playing together every now and again, and we kind of get together sometimes to actually form a proper team and try to enter some of these tournaments. So it's kind of just been fun, like, you know, getting to know people and you know, trying out for stuff. But we recently kind of just took a break, and we've all come back again, so it's been good to like play with the guys again, and like just have like I think our team is probably the best iteration that it's been.
Nice.
Out of, you know, all the mixes and matches that we've done. But yeah, we kind of just take it slow, and we're pretty chill about stuff. So,
awesome,
you know,
awesome. I got one of the biggest questions that I have to know.
Sure.
Rhaegar Lightning Shield build. What's up? What's the story there?
Honestly, I've been playing a lot of Rhaegar, and I've really been enjoying the Lightning Shield. I think especially the 16 talent is a huge. Just power spike for the character. I know the totem build is very, very popular and it's extremely good, but I've just been really liking the Lightning Shield. I've been trying it with the totem at 1 and 7, actually, and then taking the 16 Lightning Shield just mm-hmm. on its own. And I think it's good enough to take, but I don't know. I like the playstyle that it gives. I think you put it on a tank or you put it on like a gray main, and it provides a little bit of healing, and also the movement speed is not like something to laugh about too. Like, it's actually decent with the level 4 talent. And I just think it does a ton of damage at 16, and it's hard to know what kind of damage it's doing while you're playing against it. I feel like I feel like it kind of gets that sneaky, like, sustained damage in there, and I just like that playstyle.
Nice, nice. I didn't see. Have you tried that build with the elemental, with the conduit at level 20?
Oh, with the with the conduit 20, I've tried a little bit. I think I need to do more testing with that, but yeah. A lot of games, it's super hard to give up the double ancestrals. But I do, I do look forward to kind of practicing around with it.
If, I found that if there's enough clumping, like, on the enemy team for your target with the lightning shield, at least hit two.
Right.
It's going to be that the amount of sustain you get from that shield is going to be disgusting. Cause it doesn't have, you don't have to deal the damage from the Rhaegar. You can deal it. It's the damage that that your W is on. The target W
is
on.
Oh, is it? Okay. Cause I had thought that it was just the lightning shield on Rhaegar that had to do it.
Yeah, you can cast a W onto, like, Diablo, who's in there, and then, like, you just watch the shield grow on everybody, and you're like, yes.
Oh, wow, okay. Yeah, I'll have to take a look at that again then, because I definitely misread that.
I'm a Rhaegar enjoyer myself, and I'm usually toteming up, like, all the way, like, I'm talking about, like, 1-4.
Right.
You know, so I'm doing all that stuff, and then I'm also a pit fighter. Enjoyer.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. I do like Pit Fighter too. Yeah.
The 20 ancestral is really awesome in team fights, but sometimes, like, you know, just being able that extra spell power, that healing that you're getting is really substantial when you're just pressing Q, you know,
or something. Right. Yeah. But, that makes sense.
But yeah. Anyways. Oh, that's awesome. But real quick, any shout outs before we head out here? Oh, by the way, there was a question in chat.
Sure.
For the Heroes International, did you guys know? Are you guys aware of who 30K was at all, or was it just you guys just showed up?
Yeah, we definitely knew who were. we were extremely, I would say, hyped and just like kind of starstruck, you know. But honestly, though, it was really cool to kind of just have that game at such a high level and actually be competitive, and it felt really, really good for us.
Hey, I'm gonna give you some insider info here. All right.
Sure.
Let's just say they were tilted after you guys played them. All right.
So, really?
So some people were like, "Yo, what the hell's going on here? We better not lose." Yeah. that's the rumor out there. Anyways, I don't know for sure.
Really? Wow, that's awesome. No, I mean it was a great game. So honestly, all three of them.
Hell yeah. Any shout outs before we head out here?
Right. I mean, just shout out to Kags, our tank player. He's honestly the glue that holds our team together, and we really feel it when he's not there. So honestly, him just being who he is just fantastic for our team. And also just, you know, shout outs to the casters and stuff, just like getting these tournaments out there and stuff. It's great. You know, it's all the people participating in NGS. It's fantastic to see the game trying to thrive and get back there, you know.
Right on. Yeah, shout out to Kags for sure. Some big Chad plays there at the end. That was awesome.
Oh, of course. Yeah.
Well, right on. Hey, appreciate your time. Have a good rest of your week, and thanks for the games. That was awesome.
Yeah, thank you so much.
All righty, have a good one.
Yeah, you too. Bye.
All right. That was Lucy. GG, well played, y'all. That was a fantastic series, fantastic game, fantastic interview. Seems like you guys got a nice, solid team there. That's awesome to see. Good to hear. That's awesome, really. I get all emotional and whatnot. But thank you all for being here. Go ahead and drop a follow if this is the first time here. Hey, Legacy, I'm only saying what I was told. I don't know. I'm only saying what I've been told. I don't know. Oh, man. Go ahead and drop a follow if you want. Follow me on Twitter, on Instagram, on YouTube, all that jazz. I was going to stick around and just shoot the breeze for a little bit. But I do want to reset. I do want to remove the, whatchamacallit, the delay. There's a 30-second delay right now. So I do want to take that off and then hang out for a bit, just for a few minutes and just talk about HOTS. I don't know what I want to do, but just hang out, decompress for a bit before I head out for the night. But yeah, if you don't stick around, appreciate you. We'll see you on the next time. Don't forget the Crushinator tomorrow, and then